بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد this video إن شاء الله تعالى we're going to talk about briefly about the غدير خم نعم غدير خم which is we have there's 2 days left for the Shia to start celebrating غدير خم claiming that the event of غدير خم that was a time One of the claims that was a time when the Messenger of Allāh pointed Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu ardah to be Khalifa to the Muslimin. And so they celebrate this day, which took place, I believe, in the 18th of Dhul Hijjah. So they celebrate it. So I'm going to show you that the events of Ghadir Khumm does not indicate whatsoever Ali to be Khalifa. The Ali to be Khalifa. But let us go through it. So Ghadir Khumm, by the way, Ghadir Khumm, when the Messenger of Allah is a place, Prophet left after Hajj, left Mecca on the way to Al-Madina. And he mentions here that عن زيد بن أرقم قال قام رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يوما فينا خطيبا بماء يدعى خما بين مكة والمدينة فحمد الله وأثنى عليه ووعظ وذكر ثم قال ألا أيها الناس فإنما أنا بشر يوشك أن يأتي رسول ربي فأجيب وأنا تارك فيكم الثقلين أولهما كتاب الله فيه الهدى والنور فخذوا بكتاب الله واستمسكوا به فحث على كتاب الله ورغب فيه ثم قال وأهل بيت أذكركم الله في أهل بيت أذكركم الله في أهل بيت أذكركم الله في أهل بيتي so this hadith which is the hadith of al-Thaqalayn Shi'ah always try to use it. And by the way, let me clarify something. When I'm refuting the Shi'ah, al-Rafida, I know without any doubt there's some Shi'ah out there from the layman. They do love Al-Bayt. Just as some Christians, they do love Jesus. But that love they have is incorrect. That's extreme love. Now, the correct love is the love that which Allah has legislated. So when you speak to Christians, they tell you, well, you love Jesus. Sometimes, yes, they do. But it doesn't mean they are correct. Likewise, we believe some Shia out there do love Al-Bayt. But those their leaders are misusing this love to mislead them. So this advice for those sincere ones from the layman. Me personally, I believe the layman of Shia are scholars. And the scholars of Shia are laymen. Now, because the layman, they have the fitrah. Now, so this the hadith of Thaqalayn, Prophet he stood between a place called Mecca al-Madina kul Ghadir Khumm and he's advising with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to follow the book of Allah. He has guidance, light, and follow the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, hold on to it. And then he said, I remind you with Allah of Ahl-Bayt. That's why from the principles of Ahl-Sunnah to love Ahl-Bayt, to overlook their mistakes, to respect them, and from their rights. And there's another hadith which Shia always try to use and guess Ahl-Sunnah when the Messenger of Allah said about Ali من كنت مولاه فعلي المولاه نعم so this hadith when Prophet said whoever I'm a Mawlā I'm his Mawlā then Ali his Mawlā in order for us to understand some ahadith my brothers and sisters may Allah bless you all is to understand the context of the hadith so what is the context of hadith the context of hadith here he mentioned the Buraydah ibn al-Husayb. Buraydah ibn al-Husayb kept the Messenger of Allah. So the Messenger of Allah sent Khalid ibn al-Walid to Yemen. When Khalid ibn al-Walid called Ghanima, he sent someone to Prophet Sallam to send someone to split the Ghanima. So he sent to Ali ibn Abi Talib and Arda. So Buraydah ibn al-Husayb, he saw Ali ibn Abi Talib took more. What he think, so Buraydah ibn al-Husayb, he for Ali took more what he deserves. So he didn't like it. And he disliked Ali ibn Abi Talib for that. So he came back to the Messenger of Allah and he complained about Ali ibn Abi Talib and Arda. So Prophet said, you don't like him? He said, yeah, I don't like him. The Messenger of Allah said, like and love him. And he said, what he took, he deserves. Because it's from Ahl Bayt. That's the context behind it. The Prophet was to remind the people. The Prophet said, man kuntu mawla fa aliyun mawla. Another narration, Allah man wali man wala wa adi man ada. Naam? Which some scholars differ concerning the ziyada addition. Some said sahih, some said it's not sahih. But the shahid is So Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahu ta'ala, may Allah have mercy upon him, mentioned a good argument. He said, Al-Mawla, because we have, as we have mentioned, so Ghadir Khumm, no, before that, this hadith does not indicate to be Khalifa, because you believe Khilafah from Usul Iman, or Usul Islam. If it's so important, why Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam delayed this announcement until he left Mecca? Because when he was in Hajj, there was people from Yemen, people of Mecca, people of villages that surround Yemen. So that was the best time to convey the Usul of Islam. But when he left Mecca, not a lot of people with him. There were just people from Medina or people that lived near to Medina. So if it was so important for the Messenger of Allah, alayhi salatu wassalam, to convey the Ummah that Ali is a Khalifa, he would have said it in Hajj, the time of Arafah. But of course, all the Muslims are there. That's one point. Ibn Taymiyyah mentioned which is very, very good point. You cannot escape that. The second point, Mawla. Mawla, it has many meaning. Okay? For example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, وَإِن تَظَاهَرَ عَلَيْهِ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ مَوْلَاهُ وَجِبْرِيلُ وَصَالِحُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ ظَهِيرٌ. Allah mentioned the same, Mawla. So Allah said, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ مَوْلَاهُ. So Allah is Khalifa of the Prophet. And who is the Khalifa as well? And the Mu'min is Khalifa of the Prophet. So Mawla means, because Mawla means Rabb, means Sayyid, someone who is your helper, someone that you love. So Mawla means here, you love the person and you aid him and you support him. فالموالات ضد المعادات. نعم. So Mawla doesn't mean Al-Wali, because Mawla here is taken from Al-Walaya, not Al-Wilaya. الولاية مين leadership وش الولي بقى المولى taken from الولاية okay, there's a difference between الولاية والولاية so المولى taken from الولاية so this is another argument which is Ibn Taymiyyah may Allah have mercy upon him mentioned which is a good argument without any doubt. And another narration Prophet said to Buraydah, من كنت مولاه أي علي فمن كنت مولاه فعلي مولاه meaning علي is our مولى and he's and we are his موالي we love each other for the sake of Allah سبحانه وتعالى and we aid him we support him we defend him against الناصبيون those who lie against him against the خوارج so the hadith of غدير خم does not mean Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم pointed علي as a خليفة and Shia use this event and they start adding many narration. What is the other one they say? الحق مع علي وعلي مع الحق أين مدار علي الحق إيش هذا الكذب يا أخي نعم أني مش about those who support علي they will be in Jannah but we know those some of support علي بن أبي طالب some of them are خوارج they will take on him after نعم so but what makes it more clearer my brothers and sisters and we will conclude with this video with is the hadith which is in Sahih al-Bukhari, which are called Qasimat al-Dahr, the back breaker for the Rafida. Because some of us have mentioned, I'm talking about the liars, those, the heads of them. Because they come to Ahl-Sunnah, look, you have hadith of Ghadir Khumm. But the hadith of Ghadir Khumm is not clear, because Mawla has many meaning. If Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is Baligh, alayhi salam, if he intended for Ali to be Khalifa, he said, Ali is Wali al-Mu'mineen, Ali is a Khalifa. Which is clear cut. No Mawla. Mawla has many meaning. Nah? But what makes it more clearer? This hadith. Volume 8. Bab al-mu'anaqat wa qawli al-rajuli kayfa asbahta. So I will narrate this hadith in Arabic. In English I'm going to skip the Arabic. So nah, narrated Abdullah ibn Abbas. May Allah please with him. Ali ibn Abi Talib came out of the house of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam during his illness, before he died. The people ask, "Oh Abu Hassan," which is Ali, Abu Hassan, "how is the health of Allah's messenger this morning?" He replied, "He has recovered with the grace of Allah." Al-Abbas held Ali by the hand and said, "Don't you see him? He's about to die, by Allah, within 3 days you will be the slave of the stick, meaning under the command of another ruler. By Allah, I feel that Allah's Messenger will die from his present element or his illness. For I know how the face of the offspring of Abdul Muttalib look at the time of their death. So let us go to Allah's Messenger to ask him who will take over the caliphate. If the authority is given to us, we will know it. And if it's given to somebody else, we will request him so that he might tell the new ruler to take care of us. Ali said, by Allah, if we ask Allah's Messenger for it, meaning the caliphate, and he refuses, then the people will never give it to us. Besides, I will never ask Allah's Messenger for it. So this hadith is a clear one. Even a donkey can understand it. Everyone can understand this hadith. This event took way after Ghadir Khumm. So Ali ibn Abi Talib al-Wardah, he never said to Abbas, yeah, Abbas, remember, Ghadir Khumm, Prophet already appointed me to be Khalifa. He never said that to him. That is so clear. And we know that Ali ibn Abi Talib prayed behind the Messenger of Allah, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. And we know those who made the ridda, it was not Abu Bakr al-Siddiq and the Sahaba, Umar al-Khattab, because we know those who fought against the Murtaddeen, it was Abu Bakr and Umar, and Abu Bakr was the Khalifa, and Ali ibn Abi Talib fought against them under the Khilafah of Abu Bakr. So my advice, so it's clear, Ghadir Khumm is not clear. I don't know what you're celebrating for. You celebrate something unclear, because linguistically speaking, the Mawlā has many meanings. And the hadith which we have mentioned is so clear that Ali ibn Abi Talib never understood from this, the event of Ghadir Khumm that he's a Khalifa, because the context of Ghadir Khumm, the historical context, give us a clear explanation that the reason Prophet said, I'm the Mawla of Ali, because people will start speaking bad about him. So Prophet would show them the virtues of Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu wa ardah. And the last advice to Shia out there, Uqala al-Shia, Wallah, study the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if the Sahaba, they were evil, remember, those who appointed Abu Bakr to be Khalifa after the Ahadith of Rasulullah is a Muhajir and the Ansar. Those who Allah said is pleased with. And Allah will not be pleased with the evil doers, with those who will change the advice of the Messenger of Rasulullah. For the sake of argument, if you believe Rasulullah clearly advised Sahaba for Ali to be Khalifa after him. So this movement started too, for you to have a doubt about your religion, start having a doubt about the Quran. Because between us and the Messenger of Allah, the companions, if we start having a doubt about them, then you start having a doubt about the Quran. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us and to give and guide you and to make us from those for the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inwardly and outwardly. And سبحانك الله بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك وصلى الله نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وسلم سليما كثيرا